of the real fun things about getting some point of care ultrasound skills is that you'll begin to translate applications that you have learned to look for new things. So I have done a lot of point of care ultrasound for endotracheal tube confirmation and ruling out esophageal endotracheal tubes. And using that, I've been able to confirm a few cases of impacted esophageal food boluses. So a novel question with a known application. Another example of this I had recently was I managed to diagnose an orbital abscess using ocular ultrasound. I've been doing a lot of ocular ultrasound for optic nerve sheath diameter and how that might help us in kids with either acute traumatic brain injury or kids with ventriculoperitoneal shunts who might be obstructed. And that's given me a good sense of what their retroorbital tissues look like. So I had this 5-year-old boy come to the ER 24 hours after he'd been discharged from a hospital. He was in this hospital for 4 days getting IV antibiotics because he had a sinusitis that was diagnosed on x-ray, and on the same side he had developed a periorbital cellulitis. He had one of these big puffy eyes in the photos that the family showed me, but it had just gotten better every day that he'd been in the hospital getting his IV antibiotics. So they were discharged, went home, he was fever-free, but over this 24 hours, the mom was saying, he's not looking in all directions. I will put something on one side of the room and he'll look towards it, but when I put it on the other side of the room, he turns his whole head. And this 5-year-old had been traumatized by needle pokes and a stay in hospital, so it didn't matter what kind of pediatric tricks I tried to pull out of my bag. He was not interested in my examination at all. I couldn't tell you anything about his extraocular movements. And mostly what he did when I came anywhere close to him was scrunch up his eyes and cry like crazy. So I took my point of care ultrasound machine, and with the family helping me out, I managed to do a focused ocular scan. And what I was doing with this is I was trying to interrogate some of the retroorbital fat and see if I could get any kind of views to suggest that he might have an abscess or might have orbital cellulitis. Would he have cobblestoning? Could he have a discrete collection that I'd be able to see? And what we have here is an image of his right eye. On the right side of your screen is the medial side of that orbit. And you can see there's this dark stranding within the orbital fat on that side. I wasn't able to get the fullest view, but I now had a suspicion that he had an abscess or an orbital cellulitis on the medial side of his right eye. And that let me better focus my next investigations, which were a CT of his orbit, and let me feel justified that the radiation of the CT was in fact in his best interest. The CT confirmed a 1x3 cm orbital abscess on that side, and he got drained the same day. I actually saw him come back to the ER for an unrelated complaint 3 days later, looking very well. And so for other good tips or tricks for PEM POCUS, then hit us up with a like or subscribe, and we'll keep the cases coming.